guys, welcome back to my channel. So today I'm actually doing a one brand tutorial, and yes, I'm saying this, it's drugstore, of course. I actually found a drugstore brand that's really inexpensive, and they've come out with a lot of products. Really surprised that this brand is trying to dive into the more professional like aspect of makeup. I'm so excited. All in here. Yes, this bag is really huge. So, you guys wanna know what brand I'm actually doing? And I'm actually really surprised. They sell this brand at Walmart, I know for sure. I don't know about like CVS, Walgreens, Target. I think they sell it at Target. I'm not sure. But I know Walmart for sure, because that's where I saw it first. And then I saw they had it at Ulta. And I was like, what the hell? And like first they just started out with like eyeliners and mascara, and then they branched out more into like making more makeup. So we gonna do e.l.f. Yes, we are doing a one brand tutorial with only e.l.f. makeup. I know, that's crazy that I'm gonna put my face through this, but it's for you guys because e.l.f. is like really inexpensive. Like, I'm sorry, this foundation was $4. Or no, I think it was like $6. But $6 for foundation, it's like, if it works, like, hello, that's like really good. And then this eyebrow pencil was $2. Like, yeah. I have my receipt here, but I don't remember how much I spent. Let me see, actually. Yeah, the brow pencil is $2. Oh, the sponge I bought? Where is that? The sponge is only $6. And it actually looks like a really good sponge, too. Let me see. Oh, yeah. Oh, no, actually. No, that's a lie. Where is it? Oh, yeah. It was $6 foundation. So, anywho, I know this tutorial is going to be, like, really long. So, you guys might want to get like some popcorn or some cervezas or juice or whatever that fits your needs, because this is going to be a long tutorial. So you might want to get something to eat, might want to get something to drink, and we're just going to hop right into this video. Like, honestly, I have nothing else to say. So first off, we are going to go in with the Poreless Face Primer. It is basically preps your skin so makeup goes on evenly for a long-lasting matte finish, helps reduce the appearance of enlarged pores, fine lines, and shine. Infused with tea tree. Okay, whatever you say. So I'm just comes like this. Oh, this is really cute. Comes like this. Oh, this is actually a really cute packaging. Actually, it says it's a clear formula, so I kind of like any other matte, so I'm just gonna I'm just gonna apply this all over my face. I mean, it doesn't have like a bad scent, but also I'm not loving the scent per se. I mean, it reminds me of the Hourglass Veil Primer. It's very, I don't know how to explain it. So I put on primer. I'm just going to let that sit a little. So I'm going to get this highlighting and blending sponge wet. Dual-ended sculpting sponge that provides highlighting on one side, blending on the other. Let me see here. Oh, this little white thing is like this little white. I thought this was like crust, but it's like, I'm not joking, it's a little, it feels like a brush. Oh, whoa. Oh, that feels really weird. I was like expecting it to be like crust. Like, I don't know how to explain it. Like dried on makeup, like sat there and it crusted over. But no, it feels like a brush. Kind of like the Artiste brush. Wait, am I supposed to get this wet? Sweep the angled side of the sponge across the water. La, la, la. Oh, it says for an intense effect, slightly dampen the angled side and apply color. Oh, I wasn't supposed to get it wet. Oh, well. Every sponge you're supposed to get wet, but apparently Elf says no. Elf said no. It didn't say to get it wet, so whatever. Okay, what the fuck else do I have in here? Okay. Oh, this lipstick. Oh, concealer. Okay. So now we're gonna go in with the Flawless Finish foundation in Natural. Now, can you guys see the difference? This is the lightest foundation they had. They only had four foundations. Two that were light, two that were dark. And this was the lightest one they had. Now, I swatched it in the store because I'm like, am I going to do one brand with e.l.f.? Because this shade does not look like my shade. And I'm not going outside looking like I got the worst freaking self-tanner in the world. Like, nah. But I did swatch this in the store along with the other one that said it was light as well. And this one was lighter than the other one. So we're going to go with it. It says that it's an oil-free foundation. This oil-free medium to full coverage foundation achieves a flawless even satin matte base. Delivers comfortable coverage with lasting wear. Creamy blendable formula melts into the skin for a flawless looking complexion all day. All right. I'm done with that. So I'm just going to... Yeah, I'm gonna apply it on the sponge. And just see like that. And I'm just gonna do like a little bit. Oh, this is cold. And I already do not like this brush or the sponge. It's very like. Oh, this foundation smells good. And I don't know if that's a good thing. Okay. Now e.l.f. does have brushes, but I'm a more sponge person when it comes to putting on liquid foundation. I'm not a brush person at all. Mm-mm. You know what this smells like? This smells like baby lotion. I'm not lying. Oh my god. It smells like the Johnson & Johnson baby lotion after you like give your baby a bath. Oh. All right. Oh, this is gold. Scheiße. Let me try and like. Okay. Let me go. And so with this makeup, I'm only doing like a natural makeup. I'm not doing eyeshadow, even though they do make eyeshadow. And there was one palette that was really like, that really caught my attention, but I'm more of like a natural foundation type person, or I'm more of like a natural makeup type person. I'm not like a full face type person where I do like eyeshadow and highlight and contour. Actually, I'm not lying. Actually, looks like my skin tone. And I was literally gonna drag e.l.f. to the ground. Like, I was, but... Oh, wow, this actually... Wow, I'm, like, really surprised, because I was, like, so hoping that it wasn't my skin tone, that I was just gonna read e.l.f. to filth. I'm not lying, but wow. This actually... my God. You guys. First of all, can we talk about that? When this said poreless primer, it meant poreless primer. You cannot see the pores on my nose. Like, holy. I have never had makeup to where it took my pores away. Holy. I've never seen my face without pores. I'm not lying. And my pores are disgusting. Like, they're actually, wow. Okay, bitch, like, shit, I was. This primer's mine now. I usually give all of the makeup I don't want to my niece, and that primer's mine now. Oh my God. My wig is probably going to be snatched again. Holy. Wow, I can't, like, even the pores on my forehead, you can't even see. Okay, I'm done. My all right, this foundation, I actually really like it. It's not, I think you gotta build the product, honestly, to get the amount of coverage that you want. So now we're gonna go in with the HD Lifting Concealer in Fair, and this is the lightest concealer they had. And they only had, I think, like 4 concealers. I'm not sure. Oh, please tell me you're not gonna be a bitch to get out. Okay. Look how small this is. Pause. This concealer was $3. That concealer was $3. And I actually, did I swatch these concealers in the store? Hold on. No, I did not. So it comes in a doe foot. Excuse me. And I'm just gonna, this is not my skin tone at all. This is the lightest skin tone. All right, Elf, if I'm gonna say one thing, number one, make more concealer shades. Number two, make more foundation shades. And number three, get your colors correct. Does this look fair? Nah, this is fair. This is not. All right. I'm not done applying all this concealer. Here. Maybe it's like one of these magic concealers that, like, once you blend it in, it, like, turns lighter. It oxidizes into, like, a lighter shade. I don't know. Here. Here. You know what, screw it. Put it in my niece's section. I'm gonna blend this out. Concealer. I'm not lying. So now we're gonna go in and set my face. This is where I should have gotten a brush for. Oh well. So we are gonna go in with the e.l.f. HD powder in sheer. Unscrew cap, turn inner dial, la la la. HD definition loose powder creates a soft focus effect on the skin. With open and okay, no, it helps mask fine lines and imperfections for radiant looking complexion. New and improved design with open and close. Okay, no. I don't need to hear about your new and improved design.
Oh, it comes with a little puff.
How genius. Peel off and turn dial. Okay. Yeah, that's if I can peel this off. Oh, I see what it did there. Jeez Louise. Come on, Alf. At least give me a tab to use. Damn. All right. You guys see this? It says, pour powder here. Where else am I gonna pour it? On my hand? No. What the fuck? Yeah, I'm just gonna pour the powder here on my hand. The fuck? Like, no. Okay, I'm gonna use the sponge, actually, because I did not get a brush. I'm going to blend out underneath my eye any creases that ever so happened. Oh, that actually worked. Oh wow, it feels really nice. Fast because that took forever. Go. Now, finished with that. I'm gonna clean this off. Okay. Alright, so now I have my face on. So now we are gonna go in with the mascara. Yeah, right. We are gonna go in with the brow pencil in natural brown. Slim mechanical pencil shapes, defines and fills in brows for a natural polished look. Alright, so I wanted to know. So I'm gonna use this wand side to kind of brush down any of the crazy hairs that I have. This is actually really cute. And then I'm gonna do, I already know this is gonna be really dark because the other shade they had was like a reddish brown, and you think that's my skin tone? No. All right, so let's see how this works. Yeah, that's dark. Wow, that's dark. I'm gonna do the other side and then I'll blend. You see the difference? Brow on, brow off. Elf, I'm telling you, get more colors. Come on. This ain't no, like, one size fits all. I can't give this to my niece because she has blonde hair, so I'm gonna blend this out. Hopefully kind of diffuse the color a little. No. That just fucked it up even more. Oh, actually, I need to do it longer over here. Oh, that actually looks old. No, I look like I got little roly polies on my face. Alright. Got my eyebrows on, so now we're gonna go in. Oh man. Alright. I'm gonna need a brush, unless this comes with one. This is the Natural Glow Face Palette, Fresh and Flawless. If I can open this without breaking my nail. Okay, I broke the box, oh well. Oh, I need to read what it says. It says, this 3-in-1 total face palette includes Beautiful Bare Bronzer, highlighter, and 2 blushes, Weightlessly Silky Formula is perfect for sculpting and adding a soft natural dimension to the face for a fresh natural glow. Okay, done. Oh, this is cute. Look how cute that is. First of all, this highlighter, that's more of like a natural highlighter. Maybe that's what they were going for. Okay. So I'm going to use this brush, actually. This is my niece's brush. Because I didn't get a e.l.f. brush. I didn't even think I was going to use it. And I'm going to go in... Are these even named? No. What color am I going to use? Okay, I'm just going to use this color right here. These aren't even like... Okay, I'm gonna use this brush, it looks more softer. There we go. I mean, it's not like a pink color like I'm used to. It's more like a peachy. See? It's not like a pink. Okay, so now I'm going to use this brush, actually. I'm going to wipe off the excess, and I'm going to go in with this contouring shade. I'm going to lightly contour, because I want to say this is, like, very... Okay, now that I have literal shit on my, as my contour, I'm actually going to go in and kind of clean it up a little. So I'm going to take this. Let's see, where did I put it?
gonna clean that up. There. See what I did there? It looked really muddy and like really shitty. So I'm just gonna take this. And it's probably the brush that I was using, maybe, caused it to go on that way. But I'm just gonna clean up that line a little, just make it a little more crisp. Oh, I didn't contour my nose. How bad of me, fuck. Can I get this open? No. Of course not. Okay, I'm going in and I'm contouring my nose. Well, you can't even tell what the fuck I did. There we go. There. Okay. Now, let that sit. I'm gonna go in with mascara now. This is the Length and Volume. Achieve full long looking lashes. Brush head provides edge to edge control and even coating for lovely volume width. Okay. Alright, so here we go. The brush head looks like that. Very small. And now I'm just gonna go on my lash, I guess. I'll be the last one standing, two hands in the air, I'm a champion. You'll be looking up at me when it's over. I live for the battle, I'm a soldier. Yeah, I'm a fighter like Rocky. Put your flag on your back like Ali. Last and final step is lipstick. So we are gonna go in with the liquid matte lipstick in Wine Tour. Yes, e.l.f. actually makes liquid lipsticks, and I'm actually really curious to see what the hell it's gonna do to me. My lord. First of all, y'all, I already do not like. It's like not even doe foot. Okay. This is a really pretty color, not gonna lie. Alright guys, so that is it with the lips. I mean, honestly, I don't know what else I can do. It's not a doe foot application, so I can't really like perfect the lines at this point. So don't cop me for not doing my lines. Perfect. So last and final step, we are gonna go in with the e.l.f.
Mist and Set Matte Magic. It is a matte spray, I guess. This fine, clear setting spray helps makeup stay put and helps control shine for beautiful looking skin. Infused with vitamin B, E, Arsiculum, TM, Majus Root to help hydrate and soothe. Lightweight, comfortable formula helps improve makeup wearability and prevent color from running or fading. Okay, sure. What are the hiccups now? Oh,
yeah, the directions on it. I don't know where it went.
It says, shake well before use. Okay, that's all I wanted to know, if I could shake it or not. Okay, so I'm just gonna do like I normally do my setting spray. Spray the fuck out of my face. And once it comes out. Ah! My God, that spray is aggressive. It annihilated my face! That sprayed so aggressively. I was like expecting a mist. Nah. It sprayed like so, almost like the shower. I didn't intend for you to give my face a shower. Fuck. Okay, and secondly, it doesn't have a smell. And that's honestly, for a setting spray, that's not a good thing. So. Okay, so that is it for this tutorial for right now, but I will be right back because I'm going to do a wear time test, and I'm just going to wear this outside all day. I just have to run an errand for my sister, so I'm going to do a wear time test. I'm going to wear this outside, and I'll be back in a couple hours to tell you my thoughts and to give my final thoughts on this brand and whether or not it's Shandog Millionaire approved or not. So stay tuned, and I will be right back with my final thoughts. All right, guys, we are back with my check-in and basically my final thoughts on this makeup and e.l.f. as a brand. I've had this makeup on for quite a while. I went outside. I had to run an errand for my sister. So I was outside, and it was windy. It's like really windy and really cold outside, so I'm gonna take off my glasses. So first off, the makeup, I mean, it kind of held up really nicely. It didn't smudge, it didn't smear. I did cry a little because I was cutting an onion up, and so there's no like visible like marks. The lipstick, however, as you can tell, like I did eat. It's still there though, but honestly, like, I don't know. It just looks like very dry to me, like the lipstick. And it looks very like patchy in some spots. And I don't know if it's because of the food that I ate or I don't know. But I like the lipstick, don't get me wrong. I've had it on for a really long time and I ate food. But for me, honestly. And then I will say though, that this primer, oh my God, like it blurred my pores to practically nothing. It made my face look really like smooth. And I will say though, my nose isn't as oily as, and I don't know if it's this primer or whatnot, but my nose, because usually if I have my makeup on for a really long time, my nose is like, and you can obviously tell, like I had my glasses on and they have nose pads, so you can obviously see indentation from where the nose pads were. But other than that, like I do look a little shiny in my forehead, and I was cooking, so there a little heat did get on my face. But, like, honestly, like, right here, I'm a little oily. But, like, my nose in general doesn't feel, like, oily, like, at all. And so, I'm very impressed with this brand. Like, honestly, this is probably, like, one of the brands to where I was, like, okay, this brand is not legit. Like, this is more of, like, a, Oh, this brand honestly reminded me of like a brand that you would give like a little kid. Honestly, it reminded me more so for like, oh, we're gonna play around makeup, not like, oh, we're gonna be serious and indoor makeup. No. But this brand really surprised me, and honestly, this brand is Shandong Millionaire approved. Yes, it is. Like, honestly, this is approved 100%. I love the primer, first of all. The primer is, like, the greatest. The setting spray, I had no issues with, other than it sprayed my face very aggressively, and it annihilated my face with, like, water. Honestly, the eyebrow pencil, I like it. I wish it would have been in a lighter color. For me, I love the little like spoolie like at the end where I could just like, you know, brush my hairs. The concealer, I have nothing bad to say. The only thing, honestly, if I were to say anything bad about this company is your shade range. You need to have a lighter shade range, honestly, because hello, I'm pale. I'm like a pale ass bitch, and like, you make shade range for like darker people. I am like alabaster, which is like the lightest color on the planet. Honestly, I get it from my dad because my dad's like white too. And so, but honestly, I have nothing bad to say about this brand other than get a wide variety of shade range, have more colors, have lighter colors for us people that are like as white as the clouds. But other than that, I love this brand. Like, this brand, I'm gonna be using this primer in my everyday makeup routine. Hell yeah. But everything else, I might use the mascara like once in a while. I mean, it was very cute, very natural. But other than that, I might just give all this to my niece because it's like she's playing around with makeup. She's like experimenting with it now. So honestly, I just, and it's like a brand that she can afford. So when she gets older, she can be like, oh, I'm gonna go get a $2 eyebrow pencil. So that is it, guys, with this video. Other than that, I mean, honestly, the only thing I really didn't like was the lipstick because it dried really fast and it looks really patchy, and I don't like the application. It's not a doe foot application. It's just like a flat, like, but other than that, I like everything else. I like the color. I just don't like how it made my lips look very patchy. Other than that is it for this video. As always, share this with your cat, because cats are the greatest thing on this planet. I wish I could have a cat, but I cannot have a cat. So, unfortunately, I don't have a cat. But share this with your cat. If you have any other animal in this world, share this with them, because they will like my videos. It is proven and tested, maybe. I don't know. And share this with your family, share this with your friends. Share this with anyone in the world that you think would like my videos. Share this on social media, Snapchat, Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, and that is it for this video. I love you all, and I will see you again soon. Bye, guys.